afternoon and welcome to Uppercut on this very, very, very hot Tuesday.
Hi, Dave. How are you doing, Dave?
Oh, not too good, man. Not too good at all. Oh, yeah, this heat's just killing me.
It's disgusting. But you know what, Dave?
What?
Let's not talk about the weather.
Yeah. There's a lot of things been happening. How about OJ, eh?
Wow, that's too much. Was that TV or was that TV?
That's too much.
Wasn't that great? I don't know about you, and a lot of people might disagree with this, but I think I think everyone was just about watching to see him blow his head off.
Yeah.
I mean, that's what I was waiting for.
Yeah.
But what we got going now today?
Well, we got some information going to be coming up, and talk maybe a little bit about OJ, play some of our messages from the Uppercut feedback line, which of course is 812-6860.
812-6860. We still haven't got many death threats, have we?
No, we haven't got any.
We haven't got any.
Yeah, so. Anyway, something happened just recently.
Mm-hmm.
And maybe you could tell about that.
What's there to say? We've lost one of Metro's finest. What was his name again? Bayless?
I don't know.
Todd Bayless. He kind of got 187 this week, and we're kind of sitting around here wondering about that.
Well, that's too bad. Maybe we could go to some music, and then we'll come back and talk a little more about that.
Yeah, maybe we could. Ice-T.
Yeah, it was Ice-T with Cop Killer, and maybe we should do a little disclaimer.
Yeah,
because
why don't you start the disclaimer?
Well,
Dave?
First of all, if there's anybody listening out there who may be offended by certain words in the English language, please stay away from your radio or change the channel. And of course, the opinions expressed on our program are not those of CIUT or the University of Toronto,
or Sophia Cook,
mm-hmm.
Raymond Lawrence,
mm-hmm.
Marlon Neal,
mm-hmm.
Wade Lawson,
mm-hmm.
Lester Donaldson,
mm-hmm.
Louis Vega,
mm-hmm.
and the guy who got brain damage because he stole a VCR, allegedly.
Mm-hmm.
All of whom didn't have a chance either, Dave.
Yeah, and it's surprising with what's going on now. The police.
Maybe we should add Dudley.
Dudley, too. Actually, we should introduce our guest here. Say hello, special guest.
Hello, special guest. How's it going, y'all?
All right, we got Josh with us today.
Right on.
And we're going to be talking a little bit about this whole cop-killing business,
mm-hmm.
Especially with the fact now that they're saying that they need more guns to protect themselves. Well, am I mistaken, or is this like the first cop that's been shot in over 10 years?
Over 10 years, Dave. You kind of measure that up, and well,
mm-hmm.
It doesn't really add up, does it?
No,
again,
it doesn't.
When you go to police academy, what were you expecting? You know, when you want to become a cop,
mm-hmm.
I mean, do you think you're not going to get shot at?
I mean, yeah, that's part of the job.
You know what I mean?
And the thing is, more construction workers die every year than police. I mean,
well, actually, I was reading a quote there in the story, and one of the police from 12 Division was talking about how he was worried that no one was going to care too much that this happened to the cop.
Because
it's supposedly all in the line of duty, right?
Mm-hmm.
But the fact of the matter is that people get shot at every day, and nobody seems to give too much of a F*CK
mm-hmm.
about them, and
mm-hmm.
There ain't too much being said about that.
Mm-hmm.
You know, whereas when, a nice-looking girl or boy of 25, or girl of, how old was she that got shot there in the
speaking of Vivi.
Just Desserts?
Yeah.
Speaking of Vivi.
Vivi, yeah.
You know, however, when any of those people get shot, then it's like big time, you know.
Mm-hmm.
And I mean, it is quite a tragedy that, the guy was just getting his life underway, you know, 25 years old,
mm-hmm.
married, you know, just getting a house, just like, basically, he bought the farm on the idea that of job security, right?
Mm-hmm.
But he neglected to realize that his job ain't so secure, and that
mm-hmm.
He's dealing with people whose lives aren't so secure either. And they're going to do anything they can to try to get theirs.
Mm-hmm. Definitely. Now, another thing, too, like, all the talk here that you need to upgrade their weapons because they're afraid of getting shot all the time. Now, not only is it just the first police officer who's been shot in 10 years, but as we read the list here of all individuals who were shot by police, did any of them have a gun on them?
No, and as a matter of fact, those guns, they're complaining about them being old and, you know, kind of shoddy and stuff, excuse the expression, but, I'm finding more and more that they're getting kind of better with their aim. Take, for instance, the guy who shot, the cop that shot the guy with the VCR.
Mm-hmm.
Apparently he tripped, and his gun still found his skull, as in the case with Wade Lawson, which was going away at approximately 40 miles an hour, and with deadly accuracy.
And that officer was totally discharged the charges. Basically
oh,
on
yeah,
that one.
No. He was convicted. You're speaking of the guy who shot the kid with the VCR.
Oh,
whose name eludes me right now.
Mm-hmm.
He was convicted, as a matter of fact, and I believe he got something along the lines of
vacation
a rub
with
on
pay.
The wrist. On the wrist. Yeah, vacation with pay.
Vacation with pay.
But we don't want to be cynical, do we, Dave?
No. We just want to state the facts as clearly as we can state them, and I think anybody out there with any brains in their
head. Or at least as clearly as the sun, star, or globe states them.
Oh, even clearer.
Which is quite muddled.
Mm-hmm. Speaking of the sun, did you see Christy Blatchford's article?
I always read Christy
Blatchford. Christy Blatchford was condemning CIUT management for taking a... We're condemning an individual here at the station for putting on somebody who's preaching hatred towards Jews and homosexuals, a member of the Nation of Islam.
Mm-hmm.
Now, Christy goes on in her article to say that by taking this programmer off the air and disciplining her for her actions, this is totally unjust, and that denies her freedom of speech, and that she should not be held accountable for what her guests said. Well, I'm sorry, Christy, but if you know anything about the CRTC, the on-air programmer is the one responsible for the content of the show, first of all.
Nobody knows that better than us, do we, Dave?
Definitely. And secondly, if she is, wants freedom of speech so much, well, you know, Christy, I think you're probably one of the ugliest women I've ever seen in my life. And you don't smell too good either. So if you want to take me off the air for that, well, then you're just a hypocrite. And there you go. Because as far as I'm concerned, that's ridiculous.
Can we just do a disclaimer now, Dave?
Oh, yeah. The opinions expressed in the show are not necessarily mine or the station's or... University of Toronto or anybody's, I guess.
We're just the left-wing rabble showing our true colors.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
So there
it's
you go, Christy.
It's just a matter of bringing stuff up to think about, you know?
Mm-hmm.
It's a reflect thing. It's like, what's that thing on Saturday Night Live,
Deep thoughts.
Deep thoughts,
mm-hmm.
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
I think it's something like that.
Mm-hmm. Just to add some balance, Dave, I think Christy Blatchford is one of the more attractive women I've seen.
Really?
Yep. Mm-hmm. On that we'll be there sign on the TTC. Every morning I see it. It just makes me feel warm inside.
Well, as soon as she is, I'm buying a car. That's all I can say.
Okay.
Well,
then.
Anyway, let's spin another record here. We've got some mud coming at you, and then we'll be back right after this. Well, here we are back at CIUT, and that was mud.
Still in the heat.
Mm-hmm.
One of the hottest weeks I can remember.
I just want to say again, if Christy Blatchford's listening, you know, this is only my opinion. This may not be factual, but it is my opinion, and I, according to you, I have the right to free speech, so I think you're ugly, and you smell bad. Anyway, it's just my opinion, you know, and I do have the right to free speech.
To that, you're entitled.
Mm-hmm. Well, there you go.
Mm-hmm.
There you go, Christy.
Mm-hmm.
Eat it.
Mm-hmm. Onwards. Onwards, onwards, onwards.
Onwards. Anyway, this past recent couple of weeks have brought about a few events which have left some strange tastes in my mouth. And there seems to be some kind of common thread between these three events, but I'm not too sure exactly what they would be. Maybe listeners could phone in and let me know. When people are moved to riot over a sporting event, it strikes an unnerving chord in me. Filled with visions of Rome and empire, I begin to wonder what ingredients went together in this stew. So many teens, red with drink, congregate on a major avenue of consumption in downtown Vancouver. They watch their heroes go to battle in the anticipation that soon they will all consume from the same cup, the Stanley Cup. Vancouver lost. The kids were so desperate, but desperate for what? Certainly they could not have been as desperate for material goods as the people in other riots they see on TV. So if the suburban mob in Vancouver wasn't after a video camera that they could trade for a gun, or a TV that they could get a good buck for, what were they after? Oh, something more abstract? Perhaps the mob was thinking of the riots they had seen on TV in a place called the Gaza Strip. One Canadian reporter who covered the event said that the police deployment in Vancouver certainly reminded him of Gaza. So was it a religious thing? The authorities certainly reacted as if it were, as if they faced a stone-throwing, AK-47-toting group of people who are as passionately engaged in their cause as if the whole thing had something to do with human rights. Anyway, the point is that there seems to be a perceived right here, and that's the right to win, or the right to be victorious, which might be seen as the right to be able to consume or gain material wealth or wealth in some other abstract fashion. Now, when I think about what happened with OJ, and when I think about what happened with Todd Bayless,
mm-hmm.
I think about the same kind of things. I think about these kind of gains. Like, I see these kind of conflicts, these kind of struggles. It's like sporting matches played all over again. Mm-hmm. You know, OJ fleeing from the law, and the law, like, the law, you know, I couldn't figure out when I was watching that on TV, right, whether it was like, whether the whole thing took so long to fill up nice airtime on TV and give us all a little, like, preview of the movie, right?
Yeah.
Or if it took so long because the LAPD is actually now afraid to pull over a black motorist with so many TV cameras around. You know, I couldn't figure out why that whole thing scenario was being played out for so long.
Well, according to one police spokesperson, he said, they just want to treat OJ like every other murder suspect.
So how come he isn't, like, beaten with, like, you know, broken bones?
You know, I would ask the same question, but, you know, this is, how can I account for the police?
Mm. Yeah. And again, about this point of competition, and you saying, why didn't they just then beat him, right?
Mm.
You know, it's like I was talking to my friend of mine whose name isn't important about this Todd Bayless instance, and you know, he said, yeah, when I found out that guy was from 31 Division, I went, yeah, because, and he got all excited, and he said, come on, another 500, which really disturbed me, right, because this guy was talking some serious, like, you know, and he was serious about what he was saying,
mm-hmm.
and that kind of disturbed me, but, you know, when he went on to tell me about how many times he had been beaten from 31 Division and dragged down to Cherry Beach, and, you know, had his skull cracked, and
mm-hmm.
oh no, you're right, that doesn't happen here.
Oh yeah,
I don't know what
people.
Yeah.
Oh my goodness.
But on Cherry Beach, no less.
Really?
But anyway, he was telling me that the reason he was so excited was because it was actually one of the cops from the divisions that have put him under so many times for mm-hmm. A lot less than being a drug suspect.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
So, again, you know, he was saying, oh, you know, why not another 20, right? So he's looking to score more, he's looking to win more, and he's looking to gain more in some way. And it's just kind of fucked, excuse the language, how we're all kind of jammed into this conundrum of competition and trying to win
mm-hmm.
and trying to, like, gain one up on, you know, people who we have to exist with in the same city, you know?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And
yeah.
Definitely.
I'm done with that.
You know, it just plays itself out in ways that, like, you know, people don't necessarily want to be responsible for, you know. People get either excited that a cop got killed
mm-hmm.
or they get so upset that a cop got killed that they give him, like, more time than other people who get killed, like, mm-hmm. on a daily basis, right?
Mm-hmm.
Like, it just, like, it just sets up these dichotomies of competition that don't make much sense.
Mm-hmm. And it's true, especially when you look at the V.V. Lamonis thing at Just Desserts and how Mayor June Rollins went down there and went to her funeral. I didn't see her going to Wade Lawson's funeral or any of these other people that were shot by police. And it just goes to show, like what you were saying earlier, that, you know, the upper middle class, you know, nice pretty white girl, you know, it's going to be all over the media, but just, you know, some guy who's on welfare, poor guy gets shot, well, tough cock out for him, you know?
Do you mean that some people are worth more than others, Dave?
Well, that's basically the way society has been acting lately. I don't personally believe that myself. I personally don't believe anybody's more valuable than anybody else, but, you know.
So you mean there's a perception out there that there are some people that are worth more than others, mm-hmm. and there's also a perception that cops beat people when no one's looking?
Mm-hmm.
Well, it seems to be something like that, but, you know, since none of the views expressed here on this show are those held by anybody in the world, they just are free-floating...
Especially anybody who can take us off the air.
Yeah, yeah, they're just free-floating views that, mm-hmm. you know, that we simply filter through our little... you know, heads here.
Definitely. I'd just like to say one more time to Christy, if you are listening, you know, it is only my opinion. Just because it's my opinion, I think you're ugly and smell bad, doesn't mean that it's a fact. And according to your article, I'm allowed to state my opinion here as much as I want, so I'm going to do so.
And I did state an opinion that I thought she was one of the better-looking women I've seen, but I'd like to also throw in that, well, she could probably use some hooks on phonics.
Hooked on phonics, right up the road.
I just... think that, well, she's writing she's writing a little better, she's getting all her letters.
I think she's up to what, a grade 7 level now?
Yeah, well, that's, come on, she's making progress.
Yeah.
She's making progress.
Aren't you just sick of all these Sun reporters, like, writing all this, like, right-wing bullshit? Excuse the language, but
I don't care as long as they got the sunshine, girl.
The little paper that grew. The little paper that grew.
The little paper that, yeah, and anyway, maybe we should throw some more music on here and, we'll come back and we'll have, like, question of the week and some other stuff.
How about some messages when we get back?
Some messages would be good.
Okay.
Okay, so if I can find the right button, we're out of here.
I do. True, can I get a soul? Not respect you to the 1-6-2. I mean, oh, yo, check out the flow like the Hudson or PCP when I'm dusting. Niggas off because I'm hot like sauce. The smoke from the lyrical butt make me oh, what crap, my nut gets cool. Here comes my sound, let's down. True, be a bubbly. Where the f*** you see that? Feeling with the blockers, style, the rock.
And we're back here at Uppercut.
Yeah.
Sorry for the technical difficulties there, but we are running on one cart machine and it ain't running too good, so.
That was Wu-Tang.
Mm-hmm.
What was the name of that? What's the name of that cut?
That, I don't know, Dave cut it on halfway through, so I don't know what cut he put on. I was in the game.
It's this one. Oh boy. Well, we had a great show today, but
you gonna be at the funeral tomorrow, Dave?
Well, maybe, I don't know.
You know, I got my suit picked out.
If I'm not at my own.
Yeah.
Anyway, so 812-6860 is the Uppercut feedback line if you have any comments, questions, criticisms, or would like to answer a question of the week, which is,
where were you when OJ was a running?
Mm-hmm.
Running in the Ford Bronco.
Yeah, what were you doing as a little white truck sped down the highway?
So got a question, Dave.
812-6860. Call it up and check it out.
It seems like every day I hear, you can't make a 9mm anymore that doesn't jam.
Hmm.
You know?
Well, what do you
maybe
expect?
Maybe we could
right?
look into that, you know?
Yeah, maybe we could look into stuff like that. And I'd just like to say also to Christy Blatchford, if you're out there, you know, I read your article. I was really offended by it. Now, if you really want, you know, people come to be going out preaching hate propaganda, if you agree that groups should be given airtime to preach hate propaganda, you know, like, I don't know, I think we should devote a 5-minute segment of our show every week to, like, dissing Christy Blatchford for this.
Why not? We can work it in.
Yeah. And what can she say against it? She believes, she thinks people can preach hatred over the airwaves and it's all right, so hey.
Why don't we invite her down here?
And we should invite her down here.
Let's invite her down here for next week. If she's listening. Christy, you get in touch with us.
Yeah.
812-6860. You're down
6860.
Here. You're down here.
812-6860.
And you can explain yourself.
812-6860. So,
she ain't too good on the radio, though.
Now that our show is completely shot to hell, any last words?
Nope.
No? No. Well, we had Josh here today, and it was really good having you down here.
Thanks a lot for having me.
You had some really good points, and if it wasn't for you, we probably would have been completely screwed.
By the way, I'm Wixman. Never introduced myself, and neither did you, Dave.
Oh, I'm Dave. Dave Grave. The people who've been calling with death threats are out there. Thanks for not calling recently. And
I'm Wixman, the guy who's trying to sound Jewish.
Mm-hmm. And that's what they said to you on the line, isn't it?
Well, quite a few of them, yeah.
Yeah. Well, anyway, I think we should be getting out of here, and
Kevin's in Alberta.
Yes.
Yeah.
Oh, really? Anyway, so what are we going to do? Throw a tune on. And we'll be out of here. Back next week, Tuesday, 12:30, 812-6860. Please don't kill us.
of Africa.